every time you hear that da-da, 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 I mean, it's, yeah, that is Bond, isn't it?
There's something about that tune that is just classic and iconic and makes you move. And you have to honor that, right? People are so tuned into the Bond theme. There's just, you really have to be, you kind of have to deliver musical elements just because they're so great and they've become such a part of the lexicon. And then beyond that, you think, well, what can I add and how can I do something that's different but still honoring the Bond tradition?
Take the bloody shot.
Look at any scene and you ask yourself, what is it, what's it doing dramatically in terms of action, in terms of psychology, and you just try to find a way in, whether it's a chord or a rhythm or a color, a musical color, and then you kind of go from there.
007 reporting for duty.
Where the hell have you been?
Enjoying death.
I only have one question. Why not stay dead? There's no shame in saying you've lost a step.
Just the sexiness and the suaveness and kind of tuxedo vibe of Bond over the years is just, it's attractive.
Mr.
Bond, James Bond.
How much do you know about fear?
All there is.
It's daunting because you just know that it has to be a tour de force. It has to be exciting, and what does that mean musically? And you know, all eyes are, and all ears actually are you know, upon you in terms of what that is.
My name is Derek Watkins. I'm a trumpet player, and I've had the good fortune, I can only call it that, good fortune of performing on every one of the Bond films so far. This latest one, Skyfall. Very first one was Dr. No when I was 17.
Incredibly kind and nice man, and you would never guess that kind of legacy existed if someone didn't point it out to you. It's a great thing to have him in the orchestra. That just this morning we were saying, you know, when we get to these Bond licks, these classic Bond licks, we really wanted the input of Derek just to help us know that we were doing it in the right kind of way. Because it's so inbred in the experience of the English that I wanted to make sure as an American that I was kind of getting it right. So it was nice to have Derek around just to keep us in check.
As a brass player, everybody wants to be on a Bond film. It's the epitome of our session playing and all that wonderful music. It's very exciting.
Sometimes there are moments you kind of look out and you see people moving bows across strings and playing this Bond theme, and here I am conducting, and you really do think about that, this whole legacy of Bond that, you know, I've been lucky enough to be a part of.